Lodi, Wisconsin, located near the beautiful Wisconsin River and Lake Wisconsin. Founded in 1846 by Isaac Palmer in what was then the Pleasant Valley precinct of the Wisconsin Territory. He chose this location due to its water power. The Spring Creek powered a sawmill that year, and in 1850 a grist or grain mill was built. Home to Susie the Duck, a feathered local celebrity, and a ferry crossing on the Wisconsin River, a continuum of State Highway 113. It is the only free ferry in Wisconsin, and people come from far and wide just for the ride and to take in the scenery and beauty of the river. A fairly diverse population lives here in Lodi. Mostly European backgrounds, many families have been around for a long time. As of the 2010 census, Lodi has a population of 3,050, 1,224 households, and around 796 families. During the summer, people enjoy the Lodi Agricultural Fair. Activities include livestock shows and judging contests, fair rides and carnival games, and, as is the staple of many farming community fairs, a demolition derby. During the winter, residents enjoy the local curling club located next to the fairgrounds. An ice skating rink is flooded by the fire department right across the street. And the golf course is groomed by Dale Fanny for the cross-country skating team. A plethora of snowmobiling trails are put up in the local farmlands and are enjoyed by locals and passerbys alike. One of the most attractive recreational activities is the Ice Age Trail, and included in that is Gibraltar Rock. The best views of the land come from the top of Gibraltar's 1,234-foot cliff. Lodi has a few local celebrities. Tom Wopat, who played Luke Duke in the Dukes of Hazzard's TV show. Tracy Sachin, an Olympic curler who went to the Winter Olympics in 2010. Joseph Detmer also calls this quaint little town home. He is a nationally renowned decathlon athlete and even has a Thrope Cup under his belt.
Hi, I'm Kathy Scarda, and I am employed by the Lodi Police Department. I've been there for 35 years almost. Will be in February of 2018. Back in 1970 in the summer, my parents moved up here to Lake Wisconsin area. Approximately 47 years, we lived in the Dane area after I was married to my husband, and then we moved back around the Lodi area here. As a child, we used to camp at Crystal Lake Campgrounds. It used to be called Gannon's Resort. We have the wonderful agricultural fairgrounds that we utilize throughout the whole year. Brings people in from all over, have family outings. We have the ferry that people can cross and ride back and forth to go to Devil's Lake. It's kind of a neat little area, unique area, because we're not too far from Madison. We have two main highways and the interstate close by.
My name is Jim Ness. I'm the mayor of the city of Lodi. I'm supposed to be retired, but I'm run for office last year and I got elected mayor. Been involved with city council for quite some time now.
How long have you called Lodi your home?
I was born and raised here.
Can you tell us a little bit about the history of Lodi?
Well, it's changed a lot. Main Street is pretty much the same. There are different buildings, different faces now. When I was in from about sixth grade to senior in high school, I worked at the drugstore down on the corner where the smoke factory or smoke shop is now. I worked for Russ Gray, Russ and Thelma Gray. He was the druggist at the time. I graduated in 1965 and then I worked for Dick Roth for 2 years. But Lodi's changed. There, where the library is now, there used to be a feed store, and that was actually where Art Paskey started a television store back in the 60s. The karate shop used to be the theater. Post office was where Edward Jones is. The building that Peter Tunn has used to be a five and dime and a variety store and a little grocery store. We've got a lot of development that's going on more out to the north side of town. We've got a small industrial park. It's changed a lot but yet it hasn't changed. It's got the same, what I want to say, the same main street buildings that were here. So we've changed, but yet it's still Lodi.
What is an uncommon, interesting fact about Lodi?
Uncommon, interesting fact. I think the biggest thing is I find that some people like to be known for Lodi hometown of Susie the Duck, and some people don't like to be referred to as a duck. So that would probably be the biggest thing. Years ago, people come from all over just to feed our ducks. And the duck actually, Susie actually hatched in the basket there. And it used to be a big thing, and now people have gotten away from that. They don't want to be known for that. So that would be the most uncommon thing.
What is your favorite attraction or place in Lodi?
My favorite attraction is Main Street.
Why do you think Lodi keeps expanding?
People like to be here. We don't have a big industrial base, but we've got a good school system, accomplished sports in school. I'm associated with the curling club, and the high schoolers are, you know, back at the curling club now. It's just got a little bit of something for everybody, and that's the main thing.
What kind of future do you see for Lodi?
I see it growing. With the new school that we're in the planning works with right now, with the school district, it's going to continue to grow. We have different questions all the time about housing. We're getting, hopefully, we've got a couple of businesses coming in. There's a lot of talk. People are, you know, kind of loosening up with their money, so to speak, and they're willing to invest, and Lodi is a good place to invest in.
Anything else worth mentioning that I could have missed?
Just, it's a great place to stay, it's a great place to live, great place to raise your kids. Like I say, I was born and raised here. I'm the youngest of 12 kids, so my whole family grew up here. We're still, most, there's 10 of us that are still living. Most of them are, you know, pretty close to Lodi. I think the furthest one away is Portage, but we still hang pretty tight to Lodi, so, yeah.
Thank you.
You bet.
Keith Rip, serve as a state representative for the state of Wisconsin in the 42nd Assembly District, which includes Lodi and parts of six different counties. So. Grew up in the area, my family, mother's family farmed in the area, and so as I was growing up and stuff, I had an opportunity to take over the family farm, so I did that, and third generation on the family farm, so lived here my whole life, went to school here and stuff, so. Lots of history. And Susie Duck Days, of course, has been around a long time. You know, the Lodi Canning Factory has been here, you know, for generations. The Gores family, you know, a lot of history there. A lot of families have been here a long time. The Lodi Fairgrounds was a prisoner of war camp at one time. And some of those prisoners actually came back after the war and settled in this area and stuff because they liked it so much. So kind of a lot of history that, you know, a lot of people don't know about because they moved into the area and stuff. So favorite attraction. Gosh, there's several, I guess. When I was younger, Rock of Gibraltar was a popular thing. We, you know, hung around out there. Good friend of mine got married out there. And we used to ride bike, you know, this whole area. And then, so I guess there's several favorite attractions. The biggest thing I would say is, you know, Wisconsin River, Lake Wisconsin, big attraction and always has been in the area. I think it's our location to Madison, probably kind of a bedroom community to Madison and stuff. And so you can live in this area, and being in Columbia County, our taxes, property taxes and stuff are a little little less than Dane County is and stuff, so that attracts a lot of young families and stuff. And I think the newer school system we have, the newer buildings and stuff are a plus.
May we all get to grow up in a red, white, and blue little town. Get a one-star hand-me-down Ford to try to fix up. With some part-time cash and driving a tractor, find a sweet little thing, where's your ball cap backwards kind of place you can't wait to leave, and nobody does, 'cause you miss it too much. May we all